And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek The Next Generation Echoes from the Past for the Sega Genesis. I'm the RPG Chick, and I'm going to take a little break from the action. As I mentioned before, we're going to go through all the computers, archives and stuff, library, computer access and retrieval system, records, and see what's written in here. Curious to see how long the episode will be. Most likely, if it's any amount of length, over 20 minutes, which is possible, I guess. This will be a standalone episode, so anyway. Sciences. We have astronomy, physics, and time travel. Let's look at astronomy. We got space, regions, galaxy, galactic core, massive globular cluster of stars forming a galaxy's core. Interesting phenomena have been observed or postulated near the geometrical center. Energy barriers similar to the one surrounding the entire galaxy, an intense radio source. No official expedition has successfully reached the galactic core, though an unofficial one did so in the 23rd century. Sporadic communication with races in that area existed in the 24th century. Galactic disk. Stars and other matter orbiting in a plane around the galactic core. A large part of the mass and almost all of the visible matter of the galaxy exists in this relatively thin disk. Galactic edge. While the home galaxy does not have a visually definable edge, the existence of an edge phenomenon, an energy barrier, was demonstrated in the 23rd century by a ship attempting to penetrate the edge nearest Federation space. The exact nature of the energy barrier is not known. Galactic halo. A spherical region around a spiral galaxy within which all the stars belonging to the galaxy are found, particularly the ancient globular clusters. The halo contains very hot gases that emit X-rays. The stars outside the galactic disk, but within the halo, are the oldest. Sorry if I'm putting the wrong inflection at the end of sentences. I find it hard to tell the commas apart from the periods here. Home galaxy. Hold on a second. I'm going to stop for drinks now and then. The spiral galaxy containing the United Federation of Planets, known on Earth as the Milky Way. And the spiral arm. In many galaxies, the visual trace of a gravitational density wave passage caused by a large number of very young, bright, and massive stars, uncommon in the more settled regions of the galaxy. So now we're off the galaxy menu into star cluster, globular cluster. A roughly spherical, densely packed grouping of several hundred thousand stars. They are distributed within a spherical halo around the galaxy and move in highly elliptical orbits around its center. Stars and globular clusters contain low levels of elements heavier than helium. This is consistent with their having been formed from the original material of the galaxy before interstellar space had been enriched by elements only created inside stars. An open cluster. A type of star cluster containing several hundred to several thousand stars in a region a few light years across. Member stars are much more spaced out than in globular clusters. Open clusters are located within the galactic disk and are relatively young, typically containing many hot, highly luminous stars. Okay. Black hole. A region of space where the gravitational force is so strong that not even light can escape from it. Black holes are formed when matter collapses in on itself catastrophically, so that more than a critical quantity of mass is concentrated into a particular small area. It is not possible to observe a black hole directly. Their existence can only be inferred from their gravitational effects and the radiation emitted by material falling into them. Cosmic string. a hypothetical line-like defect in the fabric of space-time in the form of an infinite line or a closed loop. These tube-like configurations of energy may have arisen in the early universe, and they could have played an important role in the formation of galaxy clusters. Nebula. A cloud of interstellar gas and dust. Other objects consisting of luminous gas are also known as nebula, in particular planetary nebula and supernova remnants. Quantum filament. A closed loop of twisted space with interesting and unpredictable associated physical effects. Unlike cosmic strings, quantum filaments do not pose a danger to space traffic. However, contact with filaments is to be avoided. White hole. A hypothetical object, never observed, which has properties opposite to those of a black hole and would be a region of space where matter spontaneously appears. Could be exciting, huh? Wormhole. A tunnel-like structure in the fabric of space-time connecting two mutually remote areas of space. It is not known how they are created, but unstable wormholes do appear without apparent cause, as well as being occasionally created by malfunctioning warp drives. One artificial, stable wormhole is known to exist in the Bajor sector, connecting to the Gamma Quadrant. I believe that's by Deep Space Nine station, isn't it? Okay. So this was a submenu, and these are all... except for that one. These are all... okay. Singular entries. So, under regions and bodies of space, we have bodies, stars. And we have many different kinds of stars. Black dwarf. A dead star that is no longer luminous, formed from a white dwarf after all energy sources have been exhausted. However, the universe is not yet old enough for any black dwarfs to have formed. Really? Blue straggler. A star that appears to belong to a globular cluster or an old open cluster, but has an anomalous blue color and high luminosity in comparison with other cluster members. Brown dwarf. A very cool star with mass too low for nuclear reactions to be ignited in its core. Cepheid variable. So I'm saying that right. A type of pulsating variable star named after the group's prototype Delta Cephei, which varies between magnitudes 3.6 and 4.3 in a period of 5.4 days. The high luminosity of the Cepheids and their different luminosity periods means they play an important role as distance indicators. Formation. Stars form in clusters in the clouds of gas and dust in interstellar space. Protostar material condenses and collapses. The core heats up through the release of gravitational energy until the temperature is high enough for the nuclear fusion of hydrogen into helium to occur. Lazarus star. A supernova remnant which, instead of collapsing into a neutron star, survives as a normal star. After expansion into a red giant, Lazarus stars collapse and cause a supernova for a second time. Wow. When once just isn't enough. Neutron star. A star that has collapsed under gravity to such an extent that it consists almost entirely of neutrons. Neutron stars are only about 10 kilometers across and are incredibly dense. They are formed in supernova explosions and observed as pulsars. Speaking of which, pulsar. A rapidly rotating neutron star which emits regular pulses of electromagnetic radiation at intervals ranging from milliseconds for pulsars in binary systems to around 4 seconds. The pulses occur because the neutron star is rotating very rapidly. A beam of electromagnetic emission sweeps past an observer once per rotation. All single pulsars are slowing down as they lose rotational energy. However, some X-ray pulsars are in binary systems where complex dynamical effects cause the spin rate to speed up. Pulsars are formed in supernova explosions. Red Giant. An evolved star that has greatly expanded in size and undergone a change in surface temperature so that it appears red. A star becomes a red giant when the hydrogen fuel in its core is exhausted. Its core collapses until sufficient gravitational energy is released to cause hydrogen burning to restart, but in a shell around the now inert core. The energy generated by the shell burning causes a great expansion of the star's outer layers. As the gas expands, it cools until its surface temperature is around 4000 K. Though the light emitted per unit surface area decreases sharply, the red giant still appears luminous due to the enormous increase in surface area. Runaway star. A young hot star traveling through space with an unusually high velocity. It is thought that such stars could originally have been in binary or multiple systems where a companion star exploded as a supernova. Star. An intrinsically luminous ball of gas generating energy in its hot core through nuclear fusion processes. And white dwarf. A star in an advanced state of stellar evolution composed of degenerate matter. A white dwarf is created when a star finally exhausts its possible sources of fuel for thermonuclear fusion. The star collapses under its own gravity, compressing matter to a degenerate state in which atomic nuclei and isolated electrons are all packed together. After a long cooling-off process, the ultimate fate of a white dwarf is to become a black dwarf, a non-luminous dead star. Because that's stars. Dyson Sphere. An artificially constructed sphere surrounding a star and its planetary system. The canonical Dyson Sphere would have an internal surface area many times the total surface area of all the Federation's inhabited planets. Construction of such a sphere is beyond current Federation technology, but one such sphere has been discovered and visited by a Federation ship. Infrared signatures presumed to belong to several such spheres have been observed in Federation astronomical surveys. Planet. An astronomical body in orbit around a star which has a mass too small for it to become a star itself and shines only by reflected light. Quasar. A small extragalactic object that is exceedingly luminous for its angular size and has a high redshift. The energy source is probably the infall of matter to a supermassive black hole. I'm not sure why, guys, my voice is messed up. Roche limit. The minimum distance from the center of a planet that a fluid satellite can orbit and remain stable against tidal disruption. If the planet and satellite have equal densities, the Roche limit is 2.456 times the radius of the planet. Solid satellites can exist inside the Roche limit because the tensile strength of rock holds them together. I read star already. And supernova. What happened? I got the wrong button. Supernova. A catastrophic stellar explosion in which so much energy is released that the supernova alone can outshine an entire galaxy of billions of stars. In addition to radiant energy, 10 times as much energy is contained in the material blown out by the explosion, and 100 times as much is carried off by neutrinos. A supernova explosion occurs when an evolved massive star has exhausted its nuclear fuel. At this point, the core becomes unstable against collapse. Supernova explosions enrich the chemical composition of interstellar space from which other stars are created. Okay, so that's it for all of space. Subspace. And subspace. the state in which a starship travels from point to point at warp speeds. Subspace is not completely divorced from normal space. Stars are visible from a ship in warp drive. They do seem to flow past the ship, even when the ship is not traveling far or fast enough to justify such an effect by normal space rules. Subspace has its own rules, including its own asymptotic speed limit, similar to the light speed limit in normal Einsteinian space. Anomalies. While subspace appears to be much more uniform in nature than normal space, hypotheses offer that there are occasional variations in which its properties there are occasional variations in its properties which could have very strange and perhaps undesirable effects on a ship in warp drive. The occasional appearance of an unstable wormhole supports this theory. Subspace conduit. An artificially generated passage through subspace in which a warp bubble will be accelerated to incredible speeds approaching warp 10. And proto-universe event. A hypothetical event describing phenomena associated with a Big Bang in a parallel universe that obtruded into the known universe. Such phenomena include severe space-time distortions, energy release, and formation of new matter. This may be the source of the white hole phenomenon. Okay, so astronomy, physics, and time travel. This is the main... So we just finished sciences, astronomy. Physics. Entropy. Yeah, this is definitely going to be its own episode. Second law of thermodynamics. As a closed system moves toward the future, its entropy cannot decrease. Entropy. A measure of any system's disorganization, usually defined as the total number of accessible quantum states as measured by their relative accessibility. That's pretty heavy stuff. Time's Arrow, which is a name of an episode of Star Trek Next Generation. A colloquial term for entropy, expressing its use as a means of distinguishing between past and future through the second law of thermodynamics. Okay, matter. We got antimatter. Similar to ordinary matter, except atoms are composed of positrons orbiting about antiproton and antineutron nuclei. Physical properties are indistinguishable from ordinary matter. When matter meets antimatter, they convert one another into pure energy according to Einstein's special theory of relativity. The ability to construct antimatter developed in the 21st century made interstellar flight possible. Dark matter. During the late 20th century, evidence indicated that the galaxy was considerably more massive than could be accounted for by observed luminous or interstellar matter. The discrepancy is made up of dark matter, unobserved galactic mass. Degenerate matter. Matter existing under temperature and density conditions such that the Pauli exclusion principle prevents the formation of electron shells around the matter's atomic nuclei. Found in white dwarf stars and in the cores of some ordinary stars and planets, degenerate matter is usually incredibly dense. A small amount would weigh tons. Negative matter. First postulated by a 20th century author, I wonder who, no reliable observation of negative matter has ever been reported. Unlike antimatter, negative matter has negative gravitons and repel ordinary matter. Upon contact, the matters would cancel each other out without release of energy. Okay, paradoxes. Okay, so we got paradox. A situation in which two mutually exclusive propositions must be simultaneously true. Usually, paradoxes are merely of logical interest, but the eyeglasses loop paradox has played an important role in Starfleet decision-making. Speaking of the eyeglasses loop paradox, during a 23rd century trans-temporal mission, a Starfleet officer introduced a purported 19th century artifact taken from his home century into 20th century San Francisco. The officer in question insisted that this created a closed causal loop without cause, source, or termination. If such is the case, the artifact in question, as of that date, must, because of normal wear and tear, and the second law of thermodynamics, have had a higher level of entropy than it in fact would have had. Such circumstance creates an unresolvable paradox. And warp theory. Warp field theory. The development of warp drives is generally credited to 21st century scientist Zefram Cochran, who derived the basic mechanism of continuum distortion propulsion, CDP. The CDP concept is based on nesting layers of warp field energy, each layer exerting a controlled force against the next outer layer. The cumulative effect of these forces creates the driving force for a vehicle. Warp field coils in the engine nacelles are energized from fore to aft in sequence. The firing frequency determines the field layers required. More layers per unit time being required at higher warp factors. And warp power measurement. Subspace field stress is measured in Cochrans. Fields below warp 1 are measured in millicochrans. Field intensity for each warp factor increases geometrically, and the Cochran value required to maintain a given warp factor indicates how many times faster than the speed of light, c, a vessel will be traveling. Approximate values for integer warp factors are: warp 1 is warp 1 Cochran, 2 is 10 Cochrans, 3 is 39 Cochrans, 4 is 102 Cochrans. Warp 5 is 214 Cochrans, 6 is 392 Cochrans, 7 is 656 Cochrans, warp 8 is 1024 Cochrans, warp 9 1516 Cochrans, and that's it. Okay, so we're done with all this physics here. Time travel. Overview and slingshot effect. Overview. By the 24th century, time travel under very special circumstances is available, but not well understood. Because of several temporal near catastrophes in the 23rd century, Starfleet has embargoed time travel pending a better physical and philosophical understanding of the phenomenon. Unintentional time travel apparently occurs from time to time and may explain several historically famous occurrences. And the slingshot effect. If there is a cylindrically configured subspace pocket generated around a ship traveling at relativistic real space speeds in an intense spherical gravitational well, the ship will occasionally be precipitated directly into another region of space-time. Now there's a sentence for you. The process was discovered accidentally in the 23rd century and used several times to travel into the 19th and 20th centuries. We're done with sciences. Second menu, or main menu, cultures. Culture classification. Look at that, we got Borg, Cardassians, Ferengi, Klingons, and Romulans. Okay, so under culture, classification is cultural, healthy, arrested. Arrested culture shows no change for extended time periods. Stagnated. Stagnant culture decays socially or technologically, possibly descending into barbarism and savagery. Gradual growth is intentionally suppressed, for example, by religious doctrine or accidental, such as a dearth of resources. Catastrophic stagnation. Catastrophic causes could be natural, such as disease or adverse environs, or artificial, such as war or invasion. Okay. So under culture classification, we have environmental. Hydrogen gas giant, methane gas giant, carbon dioxide, chlorine, ammonia, organic chemicals, metallic vapors, magma. Did that make the... It makes the sound stop. The song. Asteroidal trace gases, lunar trace gases, nitrous oxide, ice, oxygen and water, land, oxygen and water, sea, zero G, vacuum, and unknown. And life form. Humanoid, mammalian, avian, aquatic, reptilian, plant, gaseous, igneous mineral, insectoid, and energy. So, the Borg. Borg race. Cool. A cybernetic race, partially organic, partially artificial life. First Federation encounter discovered the Borg 7,000 light years past explored space. The species operates as a collective consciousness via a complex of interactive frequencies across a subspace domain. Born humanoid, the species implants artificial intelligence devices linked directly to their brains. Subcommands for functions such as defense, communications, and navigation divide their consciousness. A root command controls the Borg to defend against tampering. Oops. Their collective strength entails ship and self-control and regeneration. Injured Borg are disconnected by the receiver piece and self. They seek technological consumption, not wealth or political expansion. They claim to raise the quality of life for a species they assimilate. They have annihilated several outposts on both sides of the neutral zone, as well as J-25-6. Individual Borg, when separated from the collective, show potential for creating a possible separate identity. And Borg Vessel. The Cube. The Borg Vessel is cube-shaped with outward intricate metallic latticework layers. It is capable of speeds greater than warp 9.9 and can cover 7,000 light years in 1 year. 7,000 light years being the passage into explored space. There is no scannable command center, engineering section, crew quarters, known weapons, shields, or life. The crew appears to be thousands of individual Borgs lying in stacked decks of dual rest ports. Known armament includes shield-draining energy bolts, a laser-cutting torch, tractor beams, and an unknown projection field capable of blocking Starfleet transporter beams. I need a drink. A series of three phaser blasts can damage the ship, although photon torpedoes have no effect. The ship functions even if 78% inoperable. And the Cardassians. Cardassian race. The Cardassians are a species of tall humanoids with thick ridges across their epidermis. Peace between the Cardassians and the Federation has been difficult to maintain. A recent peace treaty ended hostilities dating back to 2355. However, this peace is unstable. Cardassian warship. The Cardassian warship, Galor class, has a crew of 600 and is equipped with weapons including a compressor beam. Extreme weapon range measures 300,000 kilometers. Ferengi. The race. The Ferengi are quite short, dark, highly energetic humanoids with exceedingly large ears providing ultra-sensitive hearing, although they have poor vision. There are many levels of importance, status, and job requirement based on a caste system revolving around profits, quote-unquote. Ferengi Marauder. The Ferengi Marauder is warp-capable thanks to a matter-antimatter engine and is equipped with weapons including photon torpedoes and an energy wave weapon. Klingons. Vessels. We've got attack cruiser. The Klingon attack cruiser, Vorcha class, is the newest and most powerful in the Klingons' fleet. It uses a matter-antimatter engine and is equipped with a weapons load of disruptors and other weaponry. The forward part of the ship is normally a massive detachable disruptor. Battlecruiser. The Klingon battlecruiser is warp-capable thanks to a matter-antimatter engine, and weapons include disruptors and torpedoes. Bird of Prey. The Klingon Bird of Prey is a very versatile, small, warp-capable craft with a matter-antimatter engine and is equipped with Klingon cloaking technology. It usually has a small crew of about 12. Klingon Race. Kling, or Konos, in the homeworld of the Klingon, or is the homeworld of the Klingon Empire. The Klingons are a warrior race with a strict code of ethics and honor. Weakness, either mental or physical, is not tolerated. Previously the Federation's greatest threat, the Klingons only recently became Federation allies. Romulans. Romulan vessels. Scout. Federation records on Romulan scout ships are incomplete. It is minimally armed, warp-capable, but much slower than a warbird. Speaking of which, the warbird. Data on the Romulan warbird, the Derridex class, is incomplete. It is believed to carry a power system which harnesses X-ray emissions from a quantum singularity. Maximum warp speed is estimated 9.1. Weapons include disruptor banks and photon torpedoes. It has a cloaking device that can render the ship invisible to starship sensors, but the resulting power drain can weaken their systems. And the race. Romulans are a humanoid species distinguished by pointed ears. Romulus is the Federation name for the home star of the Romulan Star Empire. Part of a binary system, planets Romulus and Remus revolve around one another in a Trojan relationship as they circle their suns. Yikes. The Romulan Wars between Earth and the Romulan Star Empire lasted from 2156 to 2160. The Battle of Charon concluded the wars and created the neutral zone in the Treaty of Algeron. Before 2364, the last Federation contact occurred during the 2311 Tomid incident, in which thousands of Federation lives were lost. A previous alliance existed with the Klingon Empire, but has been dissolved for decades. And that's it for cultures. Alien vessels. Oh, we might not actually have to read any of this, because it's the same stuff. But we got a free pass out of that. Enterprise!